Hello, hi everyone. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. Let me introduce our artist for the night. So his name is Park Byung-chul, and he's a master Korean calligraphist. As an artist, he strives to connect the two horizons of poetry and visual art. Many of his nationally acclaimed works have been chosen for textbooks in Korean elementary and middle schools. He has also written 3 books total on the shapes of Hangul, and his works also appear frequently in advertisements, movie posters, calendars, and other printed materials today. So please welcome him to the podium.
네, 안녕하세요. 반갑습니다. 저 한국에서 온 박병철이라고 합니다. 저는 한글 글씨를 쓰고 있는 글씨 예술가 박병철이라고 하고요. 제가 보시면
Hello everyone, my name is Park Byung-chul. I'm from Korea and I'm, as Jamie just introduced me, I am a Korean Hangul calligraphist and I am very happy to be here with you tonight.
네, 여기 화면을 보시면 글씨를 뿌려 한국꽃을 피워요 이렇게 써 있는데 제 그 홀을 글씨 농부라고도 말씀드립니다.
So the words that are on the screen right now, it means I'm planting the seeds of letters to make bloom the flowers of hunger. And I like this phrase because it relates to one of my pen names, which is 글씨 농부, which means a letter farmer. I like to think of myself as planting letters and then making bloom hunger flowers. So that's how I also see myself.
네, 저는 오늘 그 여러분들께 한글과 캘리그라피에 대해서 말씀을 드리고 또 저의 글씨 이야기를 전해드리려고 합니다.
I'd like to talk to you about a little about Hangul and the calligraphy that I do, and also a little bit of my personal story as well.
그리고 또 여러분들과 함께 직접 글씨를 또 쓰고 나누는 또 시간도 갖게 될 것입니다.
We'll also, as you guys have paper in front of you, we'll also do demonstrations and really try it out ourselves as well.
오늘 이 행사의 이름이 한글 파티인데 우리 한글로 말하면 한글 잔치죠. 그래서 오늘 잔칫날처럼 즐겁고 재미나게 이 시간을 만들었으면 좋겠습니다.
I titled this whole day Hangul Party because I wanted to be like a fun and jovial party. Party in Korean is 잔치, which is a specific Korean word for party, but it's more like you know, the whole family gets together and like there's tons of food and so that's what we call 잔치 and I want this to be, you know, a fun and illuminating experience for all of you guys. Truly beautiful Hangul Korean calligraphy. Yes.
네, 한글로 꿈이란 글자입니다.
So this is one of my works and it says 꿈, and 꿈 in Korean means dreams. So that's what I tried to express with the letter 꿈.
네, 지금 한국에서는 그 한글 캘리그라피가 굉장히 크게 사랑을 받고 있는데요. 여기 지금 계신 분들도 다 한글을 좀 사랑하시는 분들이 오신 거죠?
Currently, in Korea, Hangul calligraphy is garnering a lot of attention and love. And I believe that you are here too because you also are interested in or love Hangul.
한글을 사랑하신다면 박수 한번 치면서 시작할까요?
If you guys all love Hangul, can we all give a big round of applause?
Yeah.
Thank you.
자, 그러면은 또 한글 캘리그라피도 잠깐 알아보고 시작하겠습니다. 또 한글 캘리그라피는 우리말로 캘리그라피는 영문이잖아요. 우리 한글말로 멋글씨, 멋스럽다 할 때 멋자, 멋글씨라고 표현을 하고 있는데요. 한번 멋글씨를 한번 이렇게 같이 한번 외쳐보는 것도 어떨까 싶습니다.
So calligraphy is, as you know, is, you know, an English word. But there is another word for calligraphy in pure Korean, and that is 멋글씨. 멋 means elegance and fashionable elegance, I would say, and 글씨 is letters. So can we all try and say that in pure Korean? 멋 글씨, 멋글씨. Great job, guys.
그 멋글씨라는 용어 잘 기억해 주시고요. 자, 한글로 산이란 글자입니다.
So this is the word mountain written in Hangul.
네, 그 KRP는 한국에서의 KRP는 그 전통 서예와 좀 다릅니다. 그 전통 서예가 좀 혼동하기가 쉬울 텐데 그렇지 않고요. 문방사호, 즉 붓과 벼루, 그다음에 먹과 종이를 사용하는 도구를 쓰는 것 외에는 크게 다릅니다.
So a lot of people confuse traditional calligraphy with modern calligraphy, modern Hangul calligraphy that I am doing. The only similarity is that they use the four basic elements of calligraphy, which is paper, brush, the ink stone, which you use to grind the ink, and also the ink slab and the ink stone. So those four, the paper, ink slab, ink stone, and brush. But otherwise, they're two very different things.
네, 서예는 전통 서예는 그 정해진 틀과 서법으로 뜻과 정신을 담아서 쓰는데요. 그에 반해 캘리그라피는 정형화된 틀이 없습니다.
So traditional calligraphy uses standardized writing styles and also writing ingredients to do the work, and they try to put in the meaning of the words into the standardized. Standardized format, whereas Hangul calligraphy doesn't have any sort of standardized format or restrictions.
네, 서법을 제한하지도 않으면서 또 도구와 재료도 구분하지 않고 있습니다.
It's not limited to any specific writing style, nor neither is it limited to a specific ingredient. It can be something else rather than Korean ink.
네, 그 이러한 바탕과 상상으로 뜻과 내용, 모양과 소리, 움직임 등을 도구와 재료, 서법에 제한을 두지 않고 아름다운 글꼴을 표현하는 창조적인 예술이다 이렇게 말씀드릴 수 있습니다.
So because Hangul calligraphy isn't limited to this standardized format or style, there's a lot more leeway. I wouldn't say leeway, but there's a lot more space for imagination and creativity, so that I can use the space to express meanings, content, shapes and sounds and all sorts of things through Hangul calligraphy.
자, 그러면 글씨를 보면서 좀 더 또 자세히 한번 알아볼까요?
So we'll actually get to look at some of my works and get into this a little deeper.
한글로 미소라는 글자인데요. 이 글자에서 사람의 웃는 표정이 보이시는지 한번 궁금합니다.
So this the one that's on the board right now is the Korean word miso, which means smile in Korean. Can you all see the smiling person in the letters? Yeah.
짠짠짠짠.
Right there. Yeah.
이렇게 한글은 획을 네 개의 획만으로도 사람의 표정과 또 생각과 감정을 표현할 수 있습니다.
So I think it's really ingenious because with Hangul, as you can see in this smiling face, with only four brush strokes, we can express a smiling face. And not only that, but like emotions, thoughts, and thoughts and emotions and expressions.
여기서는 또 어떤 표정이 보일까요?
So here, what kind of expression do you see here? It's the same word smile, but what is going on?
미소가 없는 찡그린 표정이죠.
Right,
슬픈 감정이 느껴집니다.
Right. He's not smiling anymore. There's you can see a certain sadness in the face.
다시 한번 볼까요? 자. 웃다가 슬프다가.
Mm-hmm. So he's smiling one second and then frowning the next.
네, 한국에서는 작년 4월에 그 세월호가 세월호라는 배가 침몰하면서 많은 사람들이 사망을 하고 지금도 실종자가 있는데요. 그때의 슬픔, 또 사람들의 그 감정, 슬픈 마음들, 표정들을 표현하고 싶어서 이렇게 미소자를 슬픈 얼굴로 썼던 글자입니다.
So I don't know if you guys are aware, but last April there was a ferry called the Sewol ferry sunk in Korea, and a lot of young people lost lives in the accident. Through this work, I wanted to express the grief and the sadness that we were all going through. I mean, it says smile, but underneath there's the sadness that is still going on.
또 다음 보겠습니다. 한국어는 표음 문자이기 때문에 또 의성어 의태어를 아주 다양하게 표현할 수 있는데요. 의성어 깔깔깔이라는 신나고 크게 웃는 소리입니다.
So in Korean there's a lot of onomatopoeic and mimetic words which are words that resemble a certain sounds or resemble certain shapes and the way people do things. So this word over here is in Korean is sounded 깔깔깔 which is an onomatopoeic word to describe the sound of laughter. When you hear something like really funny and you can't stop laughing, that's the sound that Koreans came up with. So it's like 깔깔깔. So that's the laughter you see in the words 깔깔깔.
자, 다음요. 부들부들 춥거나 무서워 몸을 떠는 행동을 표현한 것입니다.
Yes. So 부들부들 is a mimetic word which describes how you shake when you're freezing or cold or if you're scared. And that sense is expressed in these words. You can see the shakiness in the letters.
쨍그랑 유리로 된 접시나 컵이 깨지는 소리죠.
So 쨍그랑 we kind of like went over but
No.
Yes. Okay. So 쨍그랑 is also an onomatopoeic word which describes the sound that happens when you break a glass or like a glass dish. So it's like 쨍그랑. So that's you see the sharpened edges and things, that is an expression of that really like sharp and not very pleasant sound.
흔들흔들 바람에 흔들리는 모양을 표현했습니다.
흔들흔들 is another mimetic word which describes the swaying of things in a in the wind. Like leaves or if you see like a willow tree, the way that shakes would be described as 흔들흔들. And in these words you can also see that swaying.
부릉 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 자동차나 오토바이에 시동 거는 소리.
Right, you guys might have guessed what this was, but this is starting your car or a motorcycle. The sound that happens is 부릉. So yeah, that's so that's expressed in those hunger words, 부르릉.
자, 하나 더 볼게요. 둥실둥실 풍선이나 구름이 하늘에 떠 있는 느낌의 표현이죠.
So 둥실둥실 is a word that describes how balloons or clouds float in the sky. They're just kind of like floating and floating. So if you see in the words, you can also see that sort of floatiness happening. 둥실 둥실.
Mm-hmm. So are these words
that
people use currently in Korea? Oh yeah.
Absolutely.
No. Okay. Yeah. 네, 이렇게 그 다양한 글자를 보았는데요. 이게 소리와 동작 이런 느낌들을 표현했습니다. 어때 재밌었나요?
So we just looked at words that are onomatopoeic and mimetic words that are expressed through hunger calligraphy. How was it, guys? Was it interesting one?
예.
Thank you.
감사합니다. 네, 그 한글과 캘리그라피는 이렇게 서로 마주보고 손을 꼭 잡고 아름다운 한글 꽃을 또 피우고 있고요. 또 아름다운 글씨, 한글 글씨 문화를 만들고 있습니다. 한글과 캘리그라피 참 사랑스럽고 매력 있죠?
So I believe that through hunger calligraphy we're developing a new letter culture. And that people are becoming more and more interested and becoming more grateful for our alphabet, which is hunger. So, yeah, I hope this is also an opportunity for you guys to become more interested in the letter culture in Korea. 'Letters that capture hearts, the Gwanghwamun Gate Calligraphy Billboard.'
네, 그 저는 그 한글 캘리그라피가 시작된 초창기부터 시작해서 역사를 같이 하고 있는데요. 어느 순간 어느 날 아주 운명처럼 광화문 글판이라는 글씨를 쓰게 되었습니다. 아주 재밌고 즐거웠습니다.
So I've been with the development of Hangul calligraphy since its origins and beginnings. And while I was working on my craft, there was a very good opportunity to work on something called the 광화문, Gwanghwamun Gate billboard sign, which is what you see right now in front of you.
서울의 수도 광화문 광장의 그 대로변에 그 교보생명 사옥이 있는데요. 그 건물 외부에 설치가 되어 있는데 지금 현재 이 순간에 설치가 되어 있는 작품이고요. 그리고 역시 저의 글씨로 되어 있습니다.
So this building is in front of one of the palace gates of Seoul, which is called 광화문, and that building is the building of a company called Kyobo Insurance, and this is the sign that's currently on display right now in Korea.
네, 그 20년이 넘도록 봄, 여름, 가을, 겨울 계절마다 아름다운 글귀로 사람의 마음에 용기와 위안을 주면서 바쁜 도시의 삶에 쉼표가 되어주고 있습니다.
So I've been writing new billboard signs for this building for about 20 years now, and I put new signs every season, so you know, spring, summer, fall, and winter. And I really take pride in this project because I feel like, you know, people have really busy lives in Seoul, and being in the city, it can just be really just hectic. And I really like to think that people gain courage and comfort just by reading these words while they're walking in the square.
이러한 그 광화문 글판의 작업의 글씨를 쓰면서 글씨에 대한 저의 생각이 또 바뀌게 되는 계기가 되었습니다.
So actually, the opportunity to work on this project really changed my perspective on Hangul calligraphy.
네, 건물 외벽에 설치해야 되는 특성상 누구나가 읽을 수 있어야 되고 조금 먼 거리에서도 한눈에 읽을 수 있어야 되겠죠.
So because this billboard is on the walls of a building, I had to make sure that anyone from any distance could be able to read it easily and to really see the letters clearly.
글판의 글을 보는 순간 글의 내용을 이해하고 또 감동이 밀려야 되겠습니다.
I really wanted people to be able to catch the meanings of the words as soon as they read them and to really have a certain feeling or emotion that was immediately evoked just by reading the words.
멋에 치중한 글씨는 글씨를 읽는 것을, 글을 읽는 것을 방해하게 됩니다. 무슨 글자인지 알기 위해서 얼굴을 찡그리게 됩니다.
So if I focus too much on how pretty the letters look, or how fashionable they look, then it's hard for the person to really understand what the words are saying. And also, if it's too complicated or complex, then people will just have a hard time just trying to read it, and that will result in like, you know, trying too hard or frowning even because you can't get what the words are actually saying.
네, 아쉽지만 저의 글씨가 주인공이 되는 것을 포기해야 했습니다.
I was a little unwilling, but I gave up trying to make my letters the focal point of this project.
그리고 글을 쓴 사람, 또 글을 읽는 사람이 주인공이 되는 것으로 만족해야 했습니다.
Instead, I really tried in these projects to make the person who wrote these letters the main character and the person who would be reading these letters the main character.
네, 2009년도 겨울편인데요. 제가 처음으로 썼던 광화문 글판 글씨입니다.
So I'll just translate directly from Korean. So this says, I want to come to you as a snowflake comes, without hesitation, with no second thoughts.
네, 겨울편이라서 좀 포근하고 다정하게 쓰려고 했고요. 다행히 반응이 좋았었습니다.
Because it was winter time, I was trying to go for a warmth and a sort of a comfort, and I think the people received it very well.
네, 글판 이제 좀 감상을 좀 해볼까요?
So we'll move on and see a few more of the billboard signs that I worked on.
네, 2010년 가을 편입니다.
So this is, let's see. Who is near you right now? Where do you go to often? The places you go to often. The books that you read speak for who you are.
네, 2012년 본편입니다.
So this would be... You have to pay attention to know that something is beautiful. You have to look at something for a long time to know that they are someone or something to be loved. You are like that as well.
한 번 더? 됐어요? 감상된 거죠? 자, 2012년 여름편입니다.
So this would be I would like my legacy to be like stepping stones. I would like to help other people's cross and I would like to cross and give you something across the stones.
네, 2013년도 여름편입니다.
So this is, where was the child that I once was? Is he or she still inside me? Or is he gone?
네, 2014년도 본편입니다.
So this is, okay, it's a little poetic, so I'm taking a little time, sorry. How luminous the spring showers. You are like a clean and pure, you are like a clean and pure staff coming through the earth.
네, 이렇게 써야 할 내용과 쓰여질 곳을 알고 쓰는 글씨 또 이해하면서 배려하는 마음을 담아 쓴 그 글씨가 저의 글씨입니다. 저의 글씨는 점점 단단해지고 단순해지기 시작했습니다.
So I believe around this time my work started to take into consideration more the environment that the letters were going to be seen in and also the people who would be reading the letters. And as a result of that, my letters and my work became more simple, but also I feel more grounded.
네, 저는 그 이 시대를 살고 있는 함께 살고 있는 사람들의 마음 또 마음을 위로하고 용기를 주는 글씨가 쓰고 싶었습니다. 그래서 저의 그 마음을 담은 글을 또 직접 쓰면서 책을 또 담아내기도 했는데요. 또 저의 호를 또 마음이라고 스스로도 짓기도 했습니다.
So I really wanted to let my work be something that could comfort and give courage to a lot of people. And along the lines of that thought, I started writing my own short stories or short sentences and also creating work according to the words that I wrote and published them into books as well. Also because I wanted my letters and my work to capture the heart, I also, my pen name, I gave myself the pen name of Heart because I wanted to capture heart in my work.
네, 저의 그 글과 글씨, 그림을 책으로 엮어서 펴내기도 했습니다.
So, like I just said, I published a book that has my work and alongside with it, short sentences and impressions that I had throughout doing my work. So what this says here is, the world is engulfed in rain. My mother must have been lonely like this. She must have shed so many tears, more than what it is raining like now.
네, 한글로 비라는 글자인데요. 몇 해 전에 그 장마철 때 비가 굉장히 많이 내린 적이 있어요. 수없이 몇 날 며칠을 비가 내리는데 돌아가신 저희 어머니가 생각이 났습니다. 그래서 또 그립고 아 우리 어머니가 이렇게 외롭겠구나 이렇게 많은 눈물 흘리셨겠구나 하는 그런 그리움을 비라는 글자에 담아서 표현을 했습니다.
So a few years ago, early in the summer, it was raining a lot. And while I was just watching this rain, it reminded me of my mother and the loneliness she would have felt. And so the word that I wrote here is 비, which is rain in Korean. And so in these words, I tried to capture the falling of the rain and the loneliness that accompanied me a few years ago in this word.
네, 이 비라는 글자 잘 보시면은 여기 잠깐만요. 이 세로의 이의 그 세로핵은 창가에 세차게 부딪히는 빗줄기를 표현했습니다.
So if you see this long straight brush stroke here, that's the E part of P. And I was trying to express the way the rain falls down upon the window pane, like when it rains really hard, how it like just like, you know, bounces off the pane. That's what I tried to capture in this stroke.
네, 그 아침부터 저녁까지 이 빗자만 쓰고 풀었는데요. 굉장히 나중에 저녁 때 하루 종일 이 빗자만 쓰다 보니까 너무 힘들어서 한국말로 저혈당이 오는 것처럼 힘이 빠져가지고 쓰러질 것 같은 느낌 그런 어떤 느낌을 받았습니다.
So when I started working on this, I just started writing and writing that word over and over again from morning till evening and dusk, and I was just so focused on it that I was so drained, and I almost felt like I was going to faint because I was getting low blood sugar or yeah, the word actually just really drained me.
아침부터 저녁까지 쓰고 이제 무슨 차도 뿌리고 버리고 쓰고 뿌리고 그 아침부터 저녁까지 굉장히 꽤 막 나중에 힘이 없어가지고 예.
So yeah, the process consisted of me spraying like you see in this stroke, spraying the ink like over and over again. So it actually requires a lot of like arm muscle. So imagine doing that, you know, for the whole day. It was quite taxing.
자, 이렇게 비가 왔지만 그래도 힘을 내야 되겠죠?
So, you know, even though there's a time for rain, but there's also a time for sun. So what I wrote here is it's my time to shine. Go away, clouds. Clouds go away. And that is for light and sun.
네, 요거는 그 제가 그 산책하다가 길에 꺾여져 이제 버려져 있는 나뭇가지로 쓴 글씨입니다.
Oh, I see. So these words I actually wrote not with a brush, but with a twig that I found while I was taking a walk, and I found a twig on the sidewalk, and so I used that to actually write those words.
네, 이렇게 장마철에 안 되겠다. 내가 빚이 돼서 일어나서 나가야 되겠다 하고 옷을 예쁘게 차려입고 길을 나섭니다. 자신 있게.
So, this one says, here, look at me. And this Korean, this letter is 옷, which means clothes. So I was trying to be undaunted by the weather. I got into my good clothes and just set out. And you can see the person in the word clothes.
네, 한글로 옷이라는 글자가 이렇게 사람의 형상이 돼서 mm-hmm. 짠하고 뽐내고 있는 거죠.
So the letter 옷, which means clothes, you can actually see a person, you know, like flaunting her, you know, clothes and yeah, confidence.
네, 한글은 이렇게 아름답게 쓸 수 있습니다.
So I really think that Hangul is a great medium because you can express so many things with just these strokes.
네, 술 한 잔 줄이고 꽃을 사야겠어라고 되어 있는데요. 글씨에 꽃들이 만발하죠?
Mm-hmm. So this one says, today I'm going to drink one drink less and I'm going to buy some flowers. So you can see the flowers that are blooming all over the words. And it says, the next is, a household full of love, laughter, and fragrance.
이 글씨의 특징은 종이를 좌우를 뒤집어서 써서 종이를 다시 뒤집어놓은 거죠. 비치는 종이, 글씨를 거꾸로 써서 돌려놓는 거죠.
An interesting fact about this is that I used the mirror image of these words, so I would write it, you know, backwards, and then I would put it back on, and then it would come reverse, and then it would come back to what it looks like now.
네, 거울로 보면 제대로 보이는 거울 글씨라고 하면 아마 이해가 쉬울 것 같습니다.
Right. So if you put this in front of a mirror, you can read it correct. You would read the correct way.
이거 제가 한번 에피소드 잠깐 말씀드릴까요? 제가 이 글을 쓰고 원래 원문은 사야겠어가 아니고 샀어였는데 제 아내가 이걸 보고 저보고 언제 꽃을 샀냐고 하길래 제가 바로 수정을 한 거라고.
So there's a little story behind this. What it says over here is, you know, today I'm gonna, you know, drink one drink less and I'm gonna buy flowers. But the original writing said, I drank one drink less and I bought flowers. And my wife looked at it and said, when did you buy flowers? Really? Like, when did you really buy flowers? So that's when I was like, okay, I'm gonna buy flowers. So that's why I changed it to I'm going to buy flowers.
네, 자기가 언제 저보고 그러는 거죠. 자기가 언제 꽃을 샀냐고 술을 사면 샀지라고 해서 제가 아주 호되게 나중에 꽃을 이제 제가 아내한테 선물해서 잘 무난하게 넘어갔다고 전해주세요.
Right. So my wife was scolding me because she was saying if you were gonna buy something, you would buy more drinks, not flowers. So I tried to appease her by writing this, and then I went out and bought flowers for her.
네, 이렇게 열심히 세상을 살다 보니까 결혼도 해서 이렇게 꽃을 사기도 하고요. 그 다음에 사랑의 결실인 아기를 또 낳게 됩니다.
So I have a great household. I have a wife, and so we had a baby.
네, 그 아기가 노란 황금동을 산다는 것은 건강한 일이니까 참 좋은 일이겠죠.
So what it says over here is the baby lays gold, which is a fancy word for saying he just pooped. So that word 똥, the biggest word in here is 똥 means poop.
Yes. Okay.
Is poop lucky? Is poop lucky?
똥이 그 뭐지 좋은 건가요? 복스러운 건가요?
제가 이제 요 의미는 뭐냐면 아기가 노란 똥을 싼다는 거는 저에게 황금을 낳는 것 같은 느낌,
right.
건강하니까.
So I think it's more like if a baby poops like yellow poop, it's a sign that he's healthy. So they take it as a sign of, you know, good fortune. Yeah, yeah, just in that sort of, yeah.
다음 그 한글은 이제 형상으로 제가 여기서 재밌는 걸 말씀드리면은 이 똥자의 쌍디귿은 사람의 엉덩이.
If you see, look at the word poop here. I'm sorry. So the two diguts right on the top signifies the butt cheeks of the baby. If you can see the butt cheeks, yeah.
오는 똥줄기. 똥줄기.
The O, which is this thing right here is that signifies the poop.
마지막 이응은 똥 떨어지는 한 방울. 그렇게 해서 사람이 엉덩이 그게.
So so I'm so sorry. So the 이응 in the last in the bottom is a tiny droplet of poop.
네, 그리고 이 작품을 읽으실 때는 아기 똥이니까 똥 이렇게 읽으시면 안 되고 아기 똥이니까 귀엽게 똥 이렇게 읽어주시면 고맙겠다고 말씀 좀 해주세요.
So I want to ask you guys when you read this, I don't want you to say 똥 because that it's a baby's poop and baby's poop is cute, you know. So I would like you to say it, you know, lightly and in a cute way, so you wouldn't say 똥 but you would say 똥 in that
네, 그럼 또 곳곳에 아기 똥이 숨어 있는데요. 한번 보실까요? 아기 똥 하나, 아기 똥 둘, 셋, 넷, 다섯, 여섯 이렇게 아기 똥들이 또 곳곳에 숨어 있습니다.
So not only in this big letter, but just like I just pointed out, there's tiny poop, baby poop all around the words.
자. 자 이렇게 또 아기를 낳고 또 행복하게 살고 있죠. 내가 먼저 행복해야겠어.
So this means I'm sorry, but I'm gonna have to go for my happiness first. I have to be happy first. And the title of this is Now that I became a father.
세상은 빠르게 변합니다. 그리고 인간은 외롭습니다.
The times change so rapidly, and you know, we as humans, we're ultimately very lonely.
네, 내가 먼저 행복해야겠습니다.
So I feel like because of that, I feel like I really need to achieve my happiness first.
각자가 행복해야겠습니다.
So the meaning in this is not that I'm trying to like trample someone over, but that I think it's important to value an individual's happiness. And I feel like if we're all happy, you know, on an individual level, then we can be happier on a collective level.
이렇게 그 개개인이 각자가 행복해지면 우리 모두 행복한 사람들이 됩니다.
Yep.
됐어요?
Yes. These are within his book that he published.
여기서부터?
The ones that we're looking at right now. Yeah. So yeah, these are all from his book. So happy that it pains.
네, 덧칠과 수정 그리고 완성하는 시간이 오래 걸리는 그림과 달리 글씨는 며칠, 몇 날, 또 몇 달 이렇게 또 몇 년을 수없이 반복해서 쓰고 익히면서 대부분 완성이 됩니다.
So unlike paintings which take a lot of time to get like one project done, like you keep on continually making like modifications and you like put on more paint and stuff. Hunger calligraphy, it's a little different in that it does take a long process, but it's more of writing the same letters or words again and again and practicing your craft until you feel like you have a really solid grasp on what the word means and what you're trying to express through it.
네, 그 한글로 땅이라는 글자인데요. 잘 보시면 몇 초에 글씨를 쓰게 되겠습니다.
So this is the word earth in written in Hangul, and as you can see, like I just demonstrated, it doesn't take that much time. It kind of feels like it's over in a matter of seconds.
네, 그래서 글씨가 좀 쉽게 보이고 또 만만하게 보이는 경우가 있고 또 글씨보다 좀 낮게 보는 그런 어떤 경우가 좀 있습니다.
So because of the nature of my work, some people perceive calligraphy as sort of like a lesser form of art or something that's not to be as valued, right?
네. 이렇게 표면적으로 드러나는 것을 보면서 글씨의 가치가 좀 낮게 보는 게 좀 아쉽고요.
I'm quite a little disappointed about that perception that it's easier and that it's not as hard as other art forms.
네, 저의 글씨는 매일 수십 장, 수백 장 또 쓰고 버리면서 몇 날, 몇 달, 몇 년을 공들여 쓰고 익히면서 숙련한 과정 속에서 나온 생명들입니다.
Because my work isn't just something that ends in a matter of seconds. It's me myself practicing writing these words over and over again, tens of hundreds of pages that are used to write the same letters. And through this continuous writing, I try to better my craft and hone my craft. And I really feel that through writing, even if it can be a matter of seconds, I really put in my spirit and my soul into my work.
네, 땀내가 저리게 날 정도로 글씨 쓰기를 반복하면서 얻어낸 단 한 장의 글과 글씨는 나의 정신이며 마음입니다.
So the work that I get after hours and hours of practice, as I'm like raining with as I'm sweating like crazy, I feel like these words, the work really captures the spirit and the heart that I try to instill in these letters.
네, 더 멋지고 아름다운 한글을 찾기 위해 쓴 많은 종이가 폐지가 되어 버려집니다.
So because I'm constantly practicing, a lot of my work gets thrown away because if I feel like this isn't the one, then I keep on throwing it away and throwing it away.
네, 이렇게 버려지는 종이는 저의 땀과 눈물입니다.
So the paper that's thrown away in this process is really, you know, my blood, sweat and tears that's being thrown away.
과연 이렇게 쓴 글씨의 가치가 그림보다 무엇이 부족할까요?
So because of that, I disagree with the comment that calligraphy is a lesser form of art because I feel like it's just as valuable and just as beautiful.
네, 이렇게 저의 그 전부가 되어버린 글씨와 보내는 시간들이 어땠을까요? 고통으로 괴롭기만 했을까요?
So, I mean, I kind of like went into a darker side and told you I was blood, sweat, and tears, but it wasn't just all pain and suffering.
아닙니다. 좋았습니다. 즐겁고 재밌었습니다. 이 고통을 저는 즐거운 고통이라고 말합니다.
I feel like, yes, there were some painful moments, but because I loved the work so much, it was more of, it was something I was glad to throw myself into, and I feel, I like to call it a sweet pain, the process that I go through.
네, 이렇게 그 좋아서 스스로 찾아서 하는 즐거운 고통의 시간들은 나중에 그 무엇을 이루게 하는 바탕이 되는 것입니다.
I feel like the hours of sweet pain that I endured and enjoyed were really the foundation of my success in my work and my art. Hunger that thinks about humans, letters that bring good fortune.
세종대왕은 백성을 생각하여 한글을 만드셨습니다. 사람을 귀하게 여기는 세종대왕의 마음입니다.
So King Sejong, who made the Korean alphabet, which is Hunger, he made Hunger because he wanted it for the people, and he wanted a way for his people to read and write easily.
네, 그 뜻을 이어 저의 글씨도 사람을 생각합니다. 사람을 귀하게 여기는 글씨입니다.
So in that line of thought, my calligraphy also tries to think about the individual and I really try to value human beings through my work.
저의 글씨는 사람이 행복해지고 사람에게 이로운 글씨입니다.
I really want my work to help people be happier and be more courageous and to give comfort through my work.
네, 한국에서는 그 매년 새해 새해 복 많이 받으세요라는 인사를 나눕니다.
So each year in the new year, Koreans greet each other with a greeting which which is the equivalent of saying good happiness and good fortune to you in the new year.
네, 좋은 일이 많이 생기라는 인사말인데요. 사람들은 바라는 소원이 이루어지는 꿈을 꾸면서 일상생활에서 복을 빌며 또 살아갑니다.
So like the as you can see that this is a common greeting that we use in the beginning of the year. We all like to think that we live on through the year trying to achieve that happiness and good fortune.
네, 그 복을 한글로 담고 싶었습니다.
And so what I wanted to do was to capture that good fortune and blessing and happiness into my work that is Hangul calligraphy.
네, 그리고 한글로 한글을 세로로 풀어서 쓴 복글씨를 독창적으로 고안하였습니다.
So in order to do that, I developed a new style of writing which takes apart the Hangul and writes it vertically. And I developed it because I wanted to try to bring the good fortune into my work.
네, 복글씨 잠깐 보겠습니다. 행복이라는 복글씨입니다.
So this is the word 행복, and I don't know how many of you are familiar with Korean, but you can see that he's separated the certain elements that say the word 행복, and he's written it vertically. So there's the 히읗, which is the top part, and the 에 of the 행, which is over here, and then 복 is the bottom part. So he's writing them vertically rather than horizontally, which we usually would write.
네, 사랑이라는 복글씨입니다.
So this is the word 사랑, written in the style that I developed.
여기는 또 재밌는 게 있는데요. 이거는 남자, 여자.
So actually the top part is a man and the bottom part is a woman.
네, 새날이라는 복글씨입니다.
So this word means new day.
네, 대박이라는 복글씨입니다.
So 대박 would translate to
크게 성공하는
big success, big fortune.
네, 재미라는 복글씨입니다.
This word is fun in the writing that I developed.
네, 시작이라는 복글씨입니다.
This would be a beginning.
행운이라는 복글씨입니다.
And this would be luck.
처음처럼이라는 복글씨입니다.
This would translate to like the first time.
네, 한국에는 그 가장 한국적인 것이 세계적이라는 말이 있습니다.
There's a saying in Korea that means that which is most Korean is the most global.
네, 한글로 된 복글씨가 지구에 살고 있는 많은 사람들에게 알려져서 복을 함께 나누고 받았으면 좋겠습니다.
I hope that Hangul calligraphy is introduced to more and more countries worldwide and so that people can receive happiness and good fortune through my work.
네, 이제 마무리할게요. 네, 여러분들 한번 저를 따라서 말해 보시겠습니까? 나는 꽃이다.
In Korean, 한국말로요?
나는 네, 꽃이다.
네, 네. So in Korean, can you guys all follow along with me and say 나는 꽃이다? 나는 꽃이다.
여러분들은 이제 모두 한 송이의 꽃이 된 것이죠.
So what this means is I am a flower.
여러분들은 가장 아름다운 꽃입니다. 스스로에게 박수를 한번 쳐주시겠습니까?
You are the most beautiful flower on earth, and I feel like you all deserve a round of applause for being a flower on earth.
네, 자기 자신을 꽃처럼 사랑하시기 바라겠습니다. 그리고 감사하고요. 여러분들 모두의 행운과 행복을 빌겠습니다.
I wish that all of you value and love yourselves as a flower on earth, and I hope all the happiness and good fortune to you. And thank you so much for listening and coming here today.
감사합니다. 네.
Thank you.